Good morning. Just enjoying the last of my morning coffee from my Iceland coffee mug. I have quite a large collection of coffee mugs, not a large, maybe six mugs, and each of them has a different feeling to it. This was a gift for my sister, my Valentina, my Valentine sister, who enjoyed her birthday yesterday. So cheers, Tina. I didn't get a hold of you yesterday, but was certainly thinking of you, little sister. So I'll just wait a little bit for people to come on. I hope you all enjoyed a beautiful Valentine's Day. It was just another continuation. Good morning. Hey, Ricky. Hey, Annalise. Valentine's Day was wonderful. We enjoyed some chocolate and cheese fondue with some friends yesterday, which was really special. Certainly recuperating from the big dance party on Saturday night. My body was fairly stiff yesterday in my feet, so lots of 70s and 80s music, lots of bopping around. Good morning, Diane. I had this morning went back to cold immersion. I know I did the pond plunge last week, and that's going to be something I'm going to be doing a little bit more regularly. Ralph's going to cut a hole in the ice that's in a little bit of a different spot, so I won't be sliding down on the clay. But the cold water is such a great way to deal with inflammation, help bring you back into your body. So I had a ice cold 5-minute shower this morning. If you are interested in learning more about the breath work, about Wim Hof, the cold water immersion, all of that, we're starting a 3-day, hey Dan, we're starting a 3-day mini workshop. It's a free workshop that Wim Hof offers on his website, and in Embrace Your Life in our group Move It. We're going to just be sharing our experiences for people who are doing this for the first time. There's a very gentle breathing exercise, and you can learn more about how this works. Hey, Alana, good morning. Happy family day to you and your girls as well. So I love Wim Hof because all of the things that we do with the breath work, with the cold water immersion, with the commitment to the practice really brings you into yourself. And that is how we can be really connected to ourselves and feel that we are in control of things. So now that there's a few people on, just kind of segueing into a little bit more, I had a really interesting realization this morning. And it happened because our daughter hopefully has been enjoying a wonderful Valentine's Day getaway with her boyfriend, but they have two dogs, and Ollie is a 6-month-old husky, purebred husky. And although his back is, he seems to be quite slight, but he can pull. Oh my goodness. So I let the dogs out of the garage where they sleep, and on a lead, I took him out to do his business, and I was shocked at how strongly he pulls. And I thought, if I was to be standing still with this husky pulling on the lead, he would pull my arm right out of my socket. But when I decided to run along with him to see where he was running, it was a lot easier. And I was reminded of the story we tell about if you're thrown into a river, if you try to grasp onto the roots of the trees or hang on to things that are fixed to the shoreline, chances are you are going to get hurt. Whereas if you release and go with the flow, so to speak, you can navigate the obstacles coming down the river, but at least you're moving and you're not getting hurt. And I thought, yeah, like that's a very interesting thing maybe to talk about this morning. When there is lots of stuff happening, sometimes it's just so tempting to pull the blankets up over our head and just say, no, I'm not dealing with it. And you can certainly do that. You know, it's totally okay to check out for a day or an afternoon or a morning, however much time you need, just to honor that that's how you're feeling. But when you are shut down, when you are closed, number one, you're not living. You're not living vibrantly, and that's what I'm all about. I think it's not our purpose to be shuttered in and to be shut down. If you need to do that for a time to reevaluate, that's okay. But it's that whole concept of when we stop moving, are we causing any more harm? Winston Churchill was quoted as saying, "When you're going through hell, just keep going." When we are in movement, we can decide which way we're going. It's much easier to change direction if you're flowing as opposed to from a stop. And I guess that's kind of the point I'm trying to make today is if you are not sure where you're going, if you don't know where to start, if you want to make some changes in your life, you just need to create some movement, with physical movement, movement with your thoughts, movement with your breath, anything that creates flow and movement. And that's one of the reasons I've been using a lot of cypress essential oil this month. Cypress is the oil of movement. Whether it's diffused or whether I apply it to my body, it just encourages that movement. So I really want you to think about where you are right now, whether it's the global situation and you're stuck on a decision. And this is a good experience for this. If you are in a firm place in what you think is going on, I invite you to try some movement and see if you can at least shift from that place into seeing things another way. And it doesn't matter which side you're on, truthfully. I'm all about open dialogue and open conversation. Or let's say you're stuck with something with your physical body and you say, you know what, this is just what it is. I had way too many chocolates, way too much wine, way too much any of this stuff. Make a little step, create a little bit of movement, do a little 5-minute dance session to one of your favorite friends. Good morning. And just do something to create movement. When we are moving, it's a lot easier to dodge and navigate along. When we are stuck, when we are firmly entrenched, it gets a lot harder to make changes. So that's what today is all about, movement. I want you to create some movement of thoughts, movement of body, moving your breath, get those deep breathing exercises go. If you are in the Embrace Your Life community, my dear friend Yana has great meditations and breathwork exercises. If you go into Yana's corner, check those out. Hey, good morning. Yes, I was just mentioning you, Yana. So get some movement in today. Do something. It was so liberating dancing on Saturday night. Like it was just so much fun. So movement is so, so very important. You can get out walking, do lots of things. So drop in how you are moving. If you are not still in, if you're not in Embrace Your Life, I invite you to join us. I'll put the link below here. It doesn't matter if you're a girl or a guy. We have some interesting topics for guys as well as for women. But Embrace Your Life is literally about that, embracing our lives so that we can reconnect to the joy, to the passion, to the health. There's a lot of health and wellness tips in there as well. Lots of just lots of beautiful things. Everybody who does it, get in the group, gets to be a part of this, which is our raffle. We're going to be doing one at the end of the week again. I have mailed out and have the gifts set aside for everybody who did win last week. Yes, Jackie, we still have to set up your Reiki session with you. Oh, and here comes the sunshine. All right, so please move, do something, get some music going, get some flow going. Let me know what you're going to be doing, and have a marvelous, marvelous Monday. Bye. I love you all. I forgot to tell you that. But you know that. Have a marvelous Monday. Sending you much love wherever you are. It's so nice to see you all here this morning.